this is going to be the last case that lambda is a complex root. When complex roots come, it always come with its conjugate. So it is assumed that we have two dependent variables, which is x and y, and one independent variable, which is t. And then it is assumed that from our characteristic equation, we find two roots of it. One is a plus bi, and the other one is a minus bi. These two roots are complex numbers. So in that case, we just consider the complex number is just the same as the first case, which is the unrepeated real root. So the way that you find it is exactly the same as the first case, except that from the term exponential, you have the terms of exponential of bti. For bti, we are going to use the Euler expansion, Euler formula, which is saying that if you have exponential of theta I, the term of exponential theta I is equal to cos theta plus I sine theta. So instead of writing in the term of I, we are going to write term in the term of sine of n cos. Is that okay? So if you take a look at this, this might be a little bit confused because you don't know what is the capital A and capital B. But take a look at the example and you would know what I mean by that, okay? So the first example saying that find the solution of so the method itself is just starting with the same idea that you got to assume x and y. X is equal to k1 times exponential of lambda t, and y is equal to k2 times exponential of lambda t. So dx by dt is equal to k1 lambda times exponential of lambda t, and dy by dt is equal to k2 times lambda times exponential of lambda t. Okay. And from this, you just plug it back into our system, the unit system. Then we would get k1 lambda times exponential of lambda t equal to 4, k1 times exponential of lambda t minus 2, k2 times exponential of lambda t. And also we got k2 times lambda times exponential of lambda t and equal to 5k1 times exponential of lambda t plus 2k2 times exponential of lambda t. Again, these two equations, they all have the terms of exponential of lambda t, so we are going to divide both equations 1 and 2 with exponential of lambda t. From that we would get k1 lambda equal to 4k1 minus 2k2, k2 lambda equal to 5k1 plus 2k2. We arrange these two equations in such a way that we put k1 and k1 together and k2 with k2 together. So by that we would get 4 minus lambda k1 minus 2k2 equal to 0 as the equation 3, and 5k1 plus 2 minus lambda k2 equal to 0 as the equation 4. And then by equation 4, 3 and 4, we can set up the characteristic equation in order to find the lambda value. Our characteristic equation is the determinant of 4 minus lambda minus 2, 5, 2 minus lambda equal to 0. And then from this one, you find the determinant that we will get 4 minus lambda times 2 minus lambda plus 10 equal to 0. And this is, we will get what? Lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 8 plus 10 equal to 0, or lambda square minus 6 lambda plus 18 equal to 0. Okay, for this one, we find lambda 1 and 2 equal to 6 plus minus square root 6 square minus 4 times 18 divided by 2. 6 plus minus 36 minus what? 72, which is equal to minus 36. Okay, we got lambda. 3 plus 3i and 3 minus 3i. Now we got to find k. Okay, said that put lambda equal to 3 plus 3i into equation 3. So we would get equation 3, 4 minus 3 minus 3i times k1 minus 2k2 equal to 0. This 1 minus 3i k1 equal to 2k2. So k2 is equal to 1 minus 3i divided by 2 times k1. Assume k1 is equal to 1, so k2 is equal to 1 minus 3i divided by 2. So we have a set of k1 and k2. Our k1 and k2 is equal to 1, 1 minus 3i divided by 2. Okay, so our first step, x and y, x y equal to 1 minus 3i divided by 2 times exponential of 3 plus 3i. So from this we would say our x is equal to exponential of 3t times 3ti. This term we are going to use Euler. Euler saying that exponential of 3ti is equal to, I have to take a look at it, cos 3t plus I sine 3t. That is our f. And for our y, equal to 1 minus 3i divided by 2 times which is equal to to expand the exponential term of the imaginary part to become the course inside. We just do this term again, okay, so we would get y is equal to like that. We have the real part and imaginary part there. So if in case that you don't want to have like dividing term, you can assume this case equal to 2. If you assume k1 equal to 2, then your k2 is equal to 1 minus 3i. So it's going to make the equation more simple than this. Yeah.